it's Kronos, and in this video I will be announcing the giveaway winner, which will be at the end of the video, and I will also be talking about the, well, actually showcasing the new weapon moves or updates. Hope you guys enjoy. Okay, so the first weapon I would like to be talking about is the sword and shield. So, I don't think the normal sword and shield has been changed, but the heat sword and shield has. So, I guess one of the first change, or one of my favorite changes, would have to be the rolling. So before, so now you can guard a lot faster, so you can roll how you used to be able to roll with a bow. You can't anymore with the sword and shield, so that's quite nice. And now, your heat gauge, using a heat sword and shield, it goes up every time you, it still goes up when you, block, but it goes up again, you get, when your second hit, when your second counter hits. So as you can see there, after the second hit, it went up again. So you can charge the heat gauge faster now. Okay, that didn't hit. Okay, so now that the heat gauge is charged, I'll show you another thing. So now, before when you used the revenge strike, it did not increase the fatigue gauge, but now as you saw up there a bit, it did. So those are the changes with the sword and shield. Okay, so the next weapon I would like to be talking about is the jewel blade. So this update has been quite good for jewel blade lovers, I guess, with the new roll attacks. So these roll attacks are basically a way to, so jewel blades, you can roll anytime you're hitting, but after, you used to have to stop, you combo used to stop after you roll, and then you would have to restart like that, but now you have this roll attack. So you can go into a combo, roll, and then hit. So your combo sort of continues, like this. So you don't have to stop every time you dodge. And now with I guess old jewel blade, and with the normal jewel blade, you have frenzy, right? How it takes quite a while to charge. Now you can also roll into a frenzy, like insta frenzy, I guess. Tap and then hold for a frenzy, and then you go instantly into a frenzy. You can also now charge your frenzy like that. So you saw the damage there. See, it's a bit higher. Okay, that's all for jewel blades. Next, I'll be talking about the greatsword changes. Heat and normal greatswords, not soul. Okay, but some people might be happy, and some others might be upset about this change. So now, the cleaved damage and the cleave time reduction doesn't affect the soul greatsword. So some people might be upset about that. But now you also have the heat gauge on the greatsword. So this is basically an elemental multiplier. Okay, oops. Then you also have a jump cleave. So this is, I'll show the multiplier now. So now, okay, whoops. Okay, I'm not so good at using the greatsword, so just bear with it, please. But here you have the, no, please don't move. Okay, how did that not fatigue as well? Oh well, anyway, I want to show the, okay. This turtle won't stop moving. So now your pulverize does a lot more damage. elemental damage wise, as you saw there, 29,000. So the key gauge is a multiplier, I'll just show. And you can jump leap, and this charges your Magize a lot faster, and your heat gauge. As you see, your Magize is charging fast, or my Magize. And if you hit a weak marker while jump leaving, you will also instantly fatigue a behemoth. And you can also now roll out of a cleave. So before, you weren't able to, but now you can. So you can also dodge some moves. And that's all for the greatsword. The next weapon I would like to be talking about is the bow. So this weapon also has two viewing options now. So if you go to the setting options display, you have the bow aim camera. So I'll be showing A first and then B. So I'll be using it against Shadow Zarthus. So now when you aim with a bow, when you stand and aim, you have a straight line. Oh, sorry about that. Okay. And when you shoot, when you aim as well, the camera also zooms in a bit. As you see there. And the line is also straight. So this doesn't change with the crouch shot though. So the line is still a bit curved. Okay. And you can't roll as fast anymore because of the zoom. So it's harder to roll as fast. But the straight line is quite nice. And now I'll be showing camera angle B. Okay, so now I'm back and I've changed the camera angle of the bow to B type. So I guess the main difference is with the A type, the camera angle will always be on the right, whereas the left, whereas B type will differ on how you're standing. And another thing I forgot to mention is so as you see, here it would usually be only on the left side, I mean right, if it was angle A. And some behemoths, as you saw just there, have a place to hit, and you'll hit more than one damage mark. You'll deal more than one damage, if I'm saying it correctly. Okay, and finally I'll be demonstrating the new changes of the spear. So there hasn't been any changes with the heat spear, only the normal spear, and this is the, I guess, one of the best normal spears I have, the Gruten Piercer. I also have the Mufu spear, but I couldn't find any lightning behemoths to use it on. Okay, so now you have the charged lunge. So instead of pressing and releasing, you can hold down until you see a flash and then release for a lunge that deals 4 times more damage. So here you have a normal lunge, and I can charge your lunge there, and then the combo after it will deal 4 times more damage. I show again, it's charged, and you also have quite a nice effect. Okay, and now for the giveaway winners. So I basically just put everyone's names that commented there, and I put it into this fruit machine. So it was completely random. And the first winner is Arches Laurel. Congratulations. And the second winner is Black Note. Congratulations to you too. Your gems should be in your gift box by 48 hours.